Hi everyone, welcome back. This is lesson number 27. So guys, have you ever wondered how to make a comparison between two or more things in English? Well, let me tell you. One way of describing a noun is to compare it with something else, right? So we do this all the time. This usually includes words like bigger, smaller, faster, and then there's many other words that you can use to make comparisons. Sometimes actually in English, all right, English learners, so people who are not native speakers but want to learn English, they make many mistakes when using comparatives and superlatives as well. Like when they say, for example, the elephant is more big than the cat versus the elephant is bigger than the cat. Okay, so the correct answer is the elephant is bigger than the cat. Indeed, like native speakers can recognize the difference, but it's much more difficult for English learners to recognize these differences. So today I'm going to explain all that. We're going to look at many adjectives and then we're going to use them in both comparative and superlative statements. Plus, we are going to listen to a lot of examples. So are you ready? So basically guys, to make a comparison in English, you need to use as, and then you have a space here, you're gonna put words here, as, dot, 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 dot. And in the blank spot, you're gonna put either quantifiers or adjectives like you see in the list right here with all these examples. So let's take a look at a few examples using the words from the list. Nobody, not a single person, no one in the world has as much money as Jeff Bezos. So as and as. So meaning nobody has as much money as Jeff Bezos. Simple. They have as many friends as us, meaning me and you. Okay. I'm not as good as Einstein in math. Okay. You are as bad as me in chemistry. Billy is as rich as Eric. But he's not as rich as Jeff Bezos. My family is as poor as their family. That statue is as tall as this building. Okay, a building is like, you can have a skyscraper like the one in Dubai. That's a very, very big building, right? China has a lot of big buildings. New York City has a lot of big buildings. A statue is like the Statue of Liberty, okay? Statue, or there's many statues in the world. The trees are as short as a small fence. Okay, a fence is like something that you use to keep animals out, or you have a fence around your house. Okay, only you can come in the fence. Okay, it's almost like a border. It is sort of like a border fence. I'm not as thin as you. Thin, right? And then fat. Or we say skinny, and then you can also say chunky. But we avoid these words, okay? We don't say those words because we want to be polite to people. My dog is as fat as a pig. Okay, so fat, probably not a polite, super polite word to say with people, but you can make comparisons using animals or other things, all right? You can use that word fat, all right? So now guys, we're going to look at comparisons that show something to be more or less in comparison to something else. The format that we're going to use is using the verb to be, plus we have like a blank space, so you put the word here, plus er, then. Okay, for example, California is sunnier than Washington. There is more sun. Now you'll notice that, well, I'll show you, okay? Just California is sunnier than Washington. Now, notice that we changed the Y to an I in the word sunny, and then we add ER to create the word sunnier, like right here. S-U-N-N-Y, the Y becomes I, and then we add ER for sunnier. And that's because it helps the pronunciation in the spoken language, okay? So I'll write it like this. It looks like sunny. Okay, take away the Y, add an I, E-R, so it becomes sunnier. Okay, you could do it with all the words, like cloudy, for example. See that, I, it was a Y, now we put an I, and then we have E-R, cloudier. In this example, it says Washington is cloudier than Florida. Okay, so same sort of thing. Whales are bigger than elephants. Ants are smaller than cockroaches. I am smarter than them. Chickens are dumber than cows. Wrestlers are stronger than golfers. Babies are weaker than adults. Okay, some people say adults. Okay, I say adults. Okay, babies are weaker than adults. Babies are weaker than adults. Okay, you'll hear both sometimes. She is prettier than you. You are uglier than her. Okay, so notice here that we also have like big, small, smart, dumb, strong, weak, pretty, ugly. Okay, so you see those comparison words that we're talking about in this lesson. Now remember that when we use the word good, we cannot say the word gooder. We have to say the word better. So good becomes better. All right. Similarly, we cannot say the word badder when using an adjective like bad. Rather, we use the word worse. So good, better, bad, worse. So you can say something like, I am as good as you in history, but I am better than you in science. Okay, you're more good. Okay, more good. That's not grammatically correct. You are better. Let's look at another one. Okay, so I am as bad as you in running, right? Running. But I am worse than you, worse, bad, than you in swimming. Okay, like in the water, you swim. All right, now we're going to look at how to say more than something or less than something. I have more books than you. I have 5, you have 2. I have more books than you. You have less books than me. You have 2 books. I have 5 books. You have less books than me. We both have less money than her. She has $100. Me and you, we have $5. Neither of us have more dedication than him. Dedication is something that you're committed to, you want to do, like learning English. You have to have a lot of dedication. You are more intelligent than me. She is less beautiful than her. I run more quickly than the dog. I run faster than the dog. Okay, so here we have something that's a little interesting. You'll see that we have, well, when you encounter an adverb with the ending ly, like quickly, ly right there, you have to always use the form more, less, space, than with ly. Hence, I run more quickly than da 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 da. Now, here in this one, you can see it's a little different. Okay, since this word does not have an ly, you know right away, very fast, that you have to use an er. And remember that with er, you are not required to use the word more before. Hence, I run faster than the dog. Okay, er. Canadians speak more clearly than the Scottish. Same, more clearly, ly, ly. The French, on average, work less hours than the Japanese. Okay, so again, less, I should have put in red. I can fix that right now. The French on average work less hours than the Japanese. Okay, guys? All right, so we're going to move on, and let's go to the next ones. Now, when you want to compare more than 2 things, you have to use the words the most, the least, the smallest, the biggest, the tallest, okay? The most means like you have the most amount, like the most. Jeff Bezos has the most money, okay? You understand? And then we have the least, okay? Meaning you have very little of something in comparison to others. He talks the most. Nobody talks as much as him. He has the most friends. He has 1,000 friends. I only have 2. She works the least. She has the least amount of money. Okay, so you can see those examples here with the most, the least, smallest, biggest. You can use them all. In our next examples, we have to add the word est to the end of the adjective, ist. Okay, this will also alter the meaning. So let's go ahead and look at the examples and you'll notice the difference. We can see that he is the biggest in his class or in class. So here you can see that he is the biggest, est, coming from the word big. This is the worst movie of the year. Notice worst comes from worse. Okay, we take the e and we have worst, which comes from the word bad. Okay, so you'll see words like that as well. This is the worst movie of the year. I think your car is the fastest. Okay, coming from fast. Okay, here we have faster. Here we have fastest. There is no car that is faster than that car. Okay, no car. All right. So if you remember, we have the word quickly here as well. And if you want to switch it with fastest, you can drop the ly and you can add est. Thus, you can have your car is the quickest, coming from quick, right? Drop the ly, no ly, we have quickest. And finally, she thinks turtles are the slowest animals, okay? Meaning they're very slow. Nothing is as slow as a turtle. All the other animals are faster. Well, guys, I hope it wasn't too complicated for you today. Remember to practice the comparative and superlative forms with each new adjective that you learn. So if you learn an adjective like beautiful, you know that it's beautiful, more beautiful, and the most beautiful. And if you learn a word like ugly, okay, it would be ugly, uglier, and ugliest. Okay, guys? All right, that's all for now. I'll see you next time. See you later. Bye.